Hello everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today, I'm excited to introduce you to our all-in-one Cloud Crate project. It's called all-in-one because we've integrated multiple features into a single platform. This includes tools like file management, project management, a to-do list, and much more. In this video, we'll walk you through how users can register on the platform. We've implemented email verification to ensure that only verified users can complete the registration process. Let's log in the admin panel first. The admin has the ability to view and manage user details, including overseeing their profiles and activities. In the plan section, admins can add storage plans, and when a user registers, a default plan is automatically assigned to their account. For example, if a user has an active default plan with 200 megabytes of storage, they can upload up to 200 megabytes of data. To get more storage, they'll need to upgrade their plan. This is the SMTP setup section, where admins can configure their SMTP server settings, which are used for sending emails. At the bottom of this page, there's a welcome message section where admins can add their welcome email template. This template is automatically sent to users when they register on the platform. Admins can also use shortcodes to embed the user's name and email into the template. Now, let's move on to the registration process to see how it works. We will register a new account. After entering all the details when we click on Sign Up button, then it will send a 6-digit OTP to the registered email address to verify the email. As you can see, the OTP has been successfully sent to the registered email address. You have only 5 attempts to enter the correct OTP. Otherwise, a new OTP will be sent to the email. We've received our email. We've now verified our email address, and the registration has been completed successfully. After successfully registering, we've received our welcome email from the platform. If a user forgets their password, we've implemented a password reset functionality in the system. As you can see, the system has sent a password reset link to our registered email address. We've received our password reset email. Our password has been updated successfully. Now we can proceed to log in to our account. This is the user dashboard, where in the top it will show the files types uploaded in our account, and in the right side it will show us our account storage we have used. When a new user registers, then the default storage plan will automatically be added in the account. As you can see, we've now 200 megabytes of storage available. In the My File section, you'll find all of your folders and files listed here. This is the recycle bin. This is the profile section where user can update their profile picture and other details. Let's create a folder. Below the folder name, you'll see how much files this folder contains and also the size of the folder. In the top of the folder card, we've options menu where we've multiple options to manage the folder like rename, pin folder, hide or unhide folder, delete folders. You can create as many folders and subfolders as you need to organize your files effectively. At the top of the My Files section, you'll see a breadcrumb trail that helps you identify the location of your current folder. When user click on Hide button, then it will hide that folder and user need to change the folder setting to show the hidden folder. Let's create another folder. User also can move their folder and files from one folder to another. Let's move our folder 2 in the folder 1. As you can see, now our folder 2 is in the folder 1. When we click on Make Root Folder option, then the folder will be moved in the root directory of the My Files. User can upload files by just drag and drop and can upload multiple files at once. It will automatically detect the file type and show that file icon to identify the file types easily. We can rename and move our files. When you select any file or folder, it will show you Select All and a Move to Trash button, allowing you to delete multiple files and folders in a single action. When any folder and files are deleted, then it will moved in the recycle bin so user can recover them when they need it. When user recover any item, then it will be recovered to their original location. When users pin their folders, those folders will appear at the top of the My Files section and on the dashboard as well. The dashboard will also display the most recently uploaded files. You can also see that our storage has been updated, displaying how much space is currently being used. When a user uploads an image file, a thumbnail of the picture will be displayed. So, this concludes the file management features of our CloudCrate project. We will be adding more features, such as project management and a to-do list, and will keep you updated soon. For more details about our project, join us on Instagram or Telegram. We'd love to hear your feedback, so please share your thoughts in the comments section.